The years from 2035 to 2069 were a slow return to normality for the nations and corporations of the world. The cities slowly began to rebuild as trade routes were reestablished and damaged infrastructure was repaired, so technology could regain popularity once again. In the USA, many cities that were abandoned during the collapse of the early 2000s were rebuilt and repopulated. Corporations saw this as an opportunity to fix the negative public opinion they earned after the war. Many rebuilding projects were funded by them, which led them to reestablish the influence over the culture. Totally abandoned by the USA government, Night City was rebuilt by its citizens with the aid of the nomads and some smaller corporations. At the time, public opinion considered that Arasaka was made a scapegoat by the government, and most of the inhabitants of Night City would rather have the return of the Japanese corporation than submitting to the federal government. In Europe, the situation did not go as well for the old megacorps. The established players, weakened by the war, were all put in a short leash by the European national governments. In Asia, the humiliated Arasaka faced defeat with their head held high. The corporation spent a significant portion of their assets on war reparations, but a few profitable contracts allowed them to quickly regain their position as a leader in the weapon manufacturing and security industries. Internally, however, the company was a mess. Saburo Arasaka, the company's CEO for over 100 years by now, faced strong opposition which led to internal civil war. Some new, individual, isolated net networks began to emerge, mostly regional intranets. From what we know, still in 2077, we do not have an unified global network. The few connections intercity are close supervised by the NetWatch, as the fear of that dooming AR force unleashing havoc in the world is always present. At the end of 2069, the recently elected President Rosalind Myers presented a unification program to extend federal rule over the rogue free states. As most of the independence territories opposed unification, a conflict was inevitable. The federal government, backed by the now nationalized Militech forces, declared war on all dissidents. Seeing this as a good opportunity to reclaim the influence on America, Arasaka secretly supported the Free States with state-of-the-art weapons and intelligence. This conflict, fought with the most cutting-edge military tech ever seen, became known as the Meta Wars. Night City avoided open fight, but only barely. Northern and Southern California wound up in opposite sides of the war, with South aligned with the United States government and the North attempting to remain independent from the federal rule. And you guessed it right, Night City stood still in the middle of this crossfire. In early 2070s, an USA Army division advanced to the outskirts of the city, but the invasion was prevented due to the quick actions of the councilman Lucius Ryan. Lucius had a few favors to ask to Arasaka, which promptly answered in an impressive showcase of strength. Within days, an Arasaka supercarrier arrived in Coronado Bay with thousands of troops. Just a few hours later, the USA Army withdrew all the forces from the region, fearing an escalation of this conflict on what could lead to a fifth and probably the last corporate war. The United States and the Free States coalition signed a treaty of unification by then. The Free States retained their autonomy, but agreed to participate in the new federal government and to cease hostilities among themselves. Win-win-win, I guess. Only not. The peace treaty, although unsatisfactory to all parties, were profitable over war. In the aftermath of the war, Night City was rededicated as an international free city, independent from the laws and governance of the Free States of North California and the United States as well. Night City was free, but that didn't come cheap. The further increase of mega corporate influence as the corps pumped money into revitalization and security of the city was now clear. Night City became once more a haven for mega corporations, who now control almost every single aspect of the city management. Arasaka was allowed to rebuild their headquarters in the heart of the city, on the same place their old building was destroyed in 2023. Funnily enough, the Militech HQ is just across the street from the new Arasaka Tower. Between the two buildings, there is a roundabout, and at the middle of there is a memorial to the victims of the Night City Holocaust. And what about the rest of the world? Well, hurricanes and tornadoes of enormous scale intensity decimated entire populations. Haiti was officially abandoned in 2062 after a series of storms that destroyed most of the island. Hundreds of Haitians died during the event, and a few who survived migrated to the south of the USA. A large group of them lives in Night City, by the way, in the Pacifica District. For more information about them, you can check my video about the Voodoo Boys gang and also about the Pacifica District. They are both linked in the video description. For South America, Africa, and Oceania, Mother Nature have different surprises. Desertification and drought forced entire populations of those countries to become refugees. Clear water was scarce in all those regions, and the situation hasn't improved by 2077. On the other hand, in the USA, flooding is frequent. In the last 10 years, floods have destroyed parts of LA and Night City. The Netherlands lost one-third of their territory due to the rising of the sea. The Maldives were not so fortunate though, and the whole archipelago sank by the year of 2060. The global climate change led to significant soil depletion, causing famine that took hundreds of thousands of lives in the Asia and Africa. It was only by the aid of modern hydroponic and vertical city farms that some urban regions avoided total extinction. To complete the picture of this dark future, we have a dangerous and growing degree of social stratification, an enormous crime rate, and migratory unrest in almost every part of the world. Night City might look like a terrible place to live, but it is not that bad when you compare with the rest of the world. And this concludes my playlist for the Cyberpunk 2077 Timeline Explained. I hope this could give you an idea of the background story for this universe. If you miss any of my previous lore playlists, they are all linked on the video description. They are all worth checking out, so please do. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe for daily Cyberpunk 2077 content. Thank you so much for watching, and I see you next time.